Hi, my name is Dr. Stephen Merena. I'm a practicing podiatrist at the University of Vermont Medical Center, and I'm here today to talk about diabetic foot self-examination tips. Diabetic patients have a lot of complications that can occur in different parts of their body. One of the more common places to encounter problems is with your feet. The things that can lead towards problems with diabetic feet include progressive numbness in your feet called neuropathy, or circulatory changes that can make sores difficult to heal if they develop. A diabetic foot exam is important such that you can detect problems early on in the process and deal with them in a timely fashion so as to avoid some of the later problems that can be catastrophic. And when you inspect your feet, you want to make sure that you have a good light source. You want to make sure you use corrective lenses if needed. And you want to make sure that you evaluate each and every part of your foot. If we look specifically at those parts, we start with the toenails and looking around the edges of the nails in particular. In between the toes, you want to make sure that you're not seeing any sort of cracks or fissuring within the skin, and then a complete exam along the bottom of the foot. Now, for some of us, it's difficult to accurately contort yourself or look at the bottom of your foot such that you're going to get that information back. Using a mirror can sometimes be helpful. Some mirrors may be equipped with a handle that can make it easier for you to look and inspect at the bottom of your foot accurately. If this is not realistic for you, reaching out to friends or family to help you inspect your feet is an important thing to consider as well. In particular, when you're inspecting your feet, keep an eye out for bony prominences from one end of the foot to the other. In particular, look for the bony areas around your ankle, around the back or underside of your heel, and especially around the ball of the foot and toes. These are areas that can be easily irritated just from pressure from shoe gear or from either lying in bed from the pressure from the underlying mattress. As part of your foot exam, you should also make sure to inspect your shoe gear and to make sure that they're fitting you properly, looking for signs of wear and tear with the shoes, and also to reach inside the shoes to make sure there are no foreign objects that could cause problems for your feet. Now, along with a daily inspection of your feet, you should also keep these other things in mind. Proper foot hygiene is a must for every diabetic patient, and you should also look to avoid walking barefoot at all times. Make sure that the shoes that you wear fit you properly. If the problem develops, there are different ways it may present. For example, around the toenails, sometimes it'll be thickness, discoloration, or redness. Sometimes drainage from underneath the nail can present as an early warning sign or problem. In between the toes, redness, fissuring, or drainage can also occur. Open wounds or thickened skin on the bottom of your foot that can be painless can also be an early sign of a bigger problem. Your skin acts as a barrier for your entire body, including your feet, and it's important to maintain that barrier. Anytime there's a breakdown, that's an opportunity for bacteria to get in there and cause a serious problem. If you see any signs of skin breakdown, redness, or swelling, especially in the absence of pain, it is extremely important that you reach out to your healthcare professional immediately. Some diabetic foot problems can be treated fairly quickly and easily without too much interference in one's lifestyle. However, some problems can lead to more significant issues that can result in open sores with your feet. It can also lead towards infection, hospitalization, or in the worst case scenario, could result in surgery or loss of limb. So in order to avoid this, you want to stay on top of things on a regular basis.